Hello everyone, this is Vivi Cameron here, and today I'm going to be chatting about Artisa Ever Blend alcohol markers. So they come in this case, and this is going to allow you to keep organized and to carry your markers everywhere. This is exactly the same case in which you will get the Artisa Real Brush markers. Those are water-based, and they are different in size to these ones. But the case is identical, and you can also buy the case only to store there any pens, markers, or pencils you might have. And then when you open these, you will be able to surprise yourself looking at the color shades in this set. You have a variety of reds, pinks, orange, yellows, greens, blue, purple, very little brown, lots of gray, one single intense and bright neon color, and also a blender pen and some shades that you can use for skin tones and hair. So I started with an experiment that I shared in a previous video. And in that video, I'm adding colors to this image here, and it was a completely different adventure. For today, I want to simplify the things a lot more in terms of coloring, and I also want to show you more details about the markers. So you can totally disassemble this case just to place it over your desk. And the first thing you are going to notice is the shape of the marker. This is a triangular marker. It has double tip. In one end, you will have this chiseled nib that is great to add color to large areas. And this one here in the other end, that is a fine tip that is good to add color to smaller areas. You can see here some of the strokes you can create with these markers. And I was coloring for hours and I didn't feel my hands tired. They are very comfortable on the hand, and I didn't got inked fingers neither. That happened very often with other markers. Because of the bullet tip, the color application feels a little bit rough or dry, but the colors are beautiful and very intense. And the price of these markers versus other brands in the market are just unbeatable. And when I was exploring the Artisa shops, I found this treasure. Coloring books, beautiful. Don't get wrong because of that cover. There are many different kinds of illustrations inside these books, and you will find very busy and also very modern and also very loose or very simple illustrations. They are all huge. You will be able to practice coloring like crazy. I totally love this image, so that's the image I'm going to use today, but I also love this one and this one and this one and many others. I just wanted to show you this book really quick. There are 72 pages in this book and in any other of the Artisa coloring books. I have the doodles and the animals. And you know, I didn't fancy the animals book, but when I saw it inside, my goodness, there are some beautiful flamingos, parrots, insects, butterflies, and all sorts of animals you could not imagine. And I'm seriously crazy about inking this paper in many different ways with many different mediums. So I wanted to show you that and to make you feel jealous of my book collection, because they are awesome, and you will be surprised that these books cost under £10 or $10. In the video description, I'm going to be adding the links to these books and everything you have seen in this video. And in the video description, you will also find a 10% discount code that I'm going to be updating every time I get a new one. Here in my hands, I also have the Doodles book, and this is such a fun and cool book. The illustrations are very intricate though, so coloring one of these pages is going to be an adventure, but I'm sure it's going to be extremely rewarding when you finish. And this is going to give you loads and loads of practice, the perfect opportunity to improve your coloring skills. So without further ado, I'm going to show you how I added color to those beautiful peonies. I'm going to add colors from dark to light. And I choose four colors, but you can easily do this with three colors. So I'm going to start applying the darker shade of color over the edges of the image, like so. There is no mystery about the color application at all. You can go in a linear movement or you can go in small circles just to go around that edge and finish that first layer of color. Once you finish this, and this is real-time coloring, I'm going to add the next color. I just found this color on the set that is very, very close to the other one, and they blend nicely. You can barely see the seams of these colors. They look like just one single color, but they are not. You can choose skipping this color or the previous one, whatever you want. And you can also use a brown color instead, this one, for a more dramatic color combination. So the next color I'm going to use is tomato red. And this color is just one of my favorites in the whole set. You can pull with this marker the ink that I just laid down at the edge of the image, and I'm trying to blend it towards the center in circular motions and gentle, and just, this is just real time. That's all you need to do, just go around it and blend it a little bit. Then I'm going to use a pink color, and this pink color is called watermelon pink. That I didn't have idea that it will just blend so nicely with the other shades I just laid down there. So once I apply the pink color all over the petal, the colors will blend completely and you won't see any seam. And the colors, or the ink in this moment, is wet. So just allow the ink to dry. And if you find something that you don't like, you can come over and fix it. I'm going to speed the camera here because I'm going to do exactly the same for each petal. We got very little tiny petals at the top of the flower, so it's not possible to do all that blending in that small area. So what I'm going to do is to add a light color over that area, and later on I'm going to add details using color pencils. And sadly, I noticed that the camera went blur there. I really don't know why, but I missed all that part of the video, but it's not important. I want to show you that this ink will kind of bleed in the back of the paper, so it's important to place a piece of paper behind to avoid getting inked the page behind this. So that was basic blending, and then I'm going to start doing some things that are going to help me to make this image to look a lot more pretty. So I'm starting by adding this apricot color over the petals to add a hint of light on those spots. And then I also use color pencils or other markers to add more shadows and contrast to the image. I do that by applying the color on the interceptions of the petals or the edges, and then that's how I kind of rescue all those lines that I lose when I was applying the marker. Then another thing I do is alter a little bit this image. I'm just going to make the stem of the image a lot thicker, as you see there, super easy. And then I'm going to add color pencil just to add volume. For the leaves of these flowers, I was doing some crazy coloring and testing the markers there, because in the previous illustration I colored, I didn't have the chance to do that. So you will see some crazy coloring there. But the fun thing is that once the color settles or dry, everything comes together nicely and it looks cool. So I wasn't worried about the coloring of those leaves. I mixed dark and light shades of green and also yellow and orange. So here is a close-up of the coloring of the petals. I also wanted to show you this here using the camera in this position so I can show you closer what I'm doing. So you see there, sometimes I can just elongate the line, but I'm not doing anything special, but just tracing where the shadows or those kind of dark areas are going to be. And once I have this done, then I start applying the other colors in the same exact way I just explained. I'm going to speed the video here. I hope you enjoyed the coloring process. I'm really loving the vibrancy of these colors. I have not complained about the Artisa Everblend alcohol markers. I'm not an expert colorist, and they made me feel as I know what I was doing, and it was so easy to blend the color and to achieve a result that it makes me happy. It might not be perfect, but it's okay for what I do, that is paper craft and card making. Although the ink of the markers are going to transfer at the back of this paper because this is only 100 pounds paper and it's thin, I really think that you can use the pages of the coloring books for card making as well. You can cut a piece of those large panels. It doesn't have to be the whole panel. You can also do decoupage, or you can also use the coloring book pages for other craft projects. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel or visit my blog for more ideas and inspiration. Check supply list and my 10% discount code to the Artisa shops in the video description. Thank you very much for watching, and happy crafting. Bye.